dogma of America. America is the only place on earth where you will be criticized and slandered for voting for who you really want to vote for. All I ever hear all day long is vote for Kamala Harris, vote for Kamala Harris, all from Democrats. So whatever happened to my body, my choice? Or does that only apply to people who want to murder babies? Well, fuck that. It's my vote, my choice, and nobody will get hurt if I vote for Trump. I'll hand the Democrats only one thing. They know how to manipulate people very well, but only people who are weak-minded individuals. Did you hear me? Yes. If you vote for Kamala Harris, you are weak. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. Buts about it. Of course, if you're shallow enough to vote for someone based solely on race, color, and lack of religion, then be my guest. But that's really all Kamala has going for her, except to call people who don't like her little kitty names like ugly and sissy. Well, let me tell you, if you are a real man, you won't let what Kamala Harris or her little wussy supporters say bother you. I even heard of a woman saying that Kamala supporting men are sexy. What? I've seen men who support Kamala, and they look too feminine to be sexy to anyone, except maybe a lesbian. And they don't count. They couldn't look like real men if they wore cowboy hats and heavily worn jeans. And this bullshit she's always bringing up, Trump's accountability. What the hell is with this accountability thing? We're all sick of hearing it. It's never anything but, this is Trump's fault, and that is Trump's fault. And Trump's fault, and blah blah blah, every time she opens her mouth. Fuck that. How about you stop blaming Trump and start taking accountability for your own actions, you fool? It's been the same thing with every administration since I've been alive. Clinton blamed Reagan. Bush blamed Clinton. Obama blamed Bush. And now Biden and Harris are blaming Trump. The only difference is Biden, Obama, and Harris never stop blaming others for their own faults and failures. It isn't Trump's fault our border czar didn't do her job right. She handled illegals with such soft kid gloves, she did nothing but beg them not to come. As if that's supposed to work. If she had handled the border the way Trump did, the illegals would not have come, and people like Lake and Riley would still be alive. So don't blame Trump for that. You cannot blame someone else for your major malfunctions, and then expect them to take accountability for anything. You may not like it, but that's how the world works. You fuck up, you take accountability. Until then, shut up and leave Trump alone. Kamala supporters are so dumb, the pandemic is over, and they still wear masks on their nose and mouth. Outside yet. Even when the pandemic was still believed to be out there, you didn't have to wear masks outside for Christ's sake. Only in smaller enclosed spaces like inside a store, you dumb bastards. Nobody looks very secure with themselves wearing a mask. Being secure in oneself is the epitome of being a real man or a real woman. And now that the stupid pandemic is over, you all can get over yourselves and throw the mask away. Another thing that annoys me about people who support Kamala Harris. They keep saying that Trump supporters never do any research. Are you sure of that? It's the Trump supporters who seem to do the most research. I think the Kamala Harris supporters are simply jealous because all they have are what the mainstream media says about Kamala Harris versus Donald Trump. Trump supporters do not listen to mainstream media, and I find it annoys the fuck out of Kamala Harris supporters. But what is more manly than a guy who's been shot and gets back up, pumping his fist in the air, shouting, fight, fight, fight? If Kamala Harris had been shot, she'd be dead right now because she's so weak. She would have given up, and she probably would have been crying and whining as she went out. She doesn't impress me at all. If we have nuclear war in this country, the only things left would probably be cockroaches and Trumps. Kamala Harris would never survive that. She'd hide away in her little bunker or her mom's basement. So you make the choice. Are you going to vote for a man's man who bravely dodges bullets and everything else the media throws at him? Or are you going to be shallow and vote for someone who always wants to be a victim and whose only assets are her skin color and what organ is between her legs? I don't know what you think, but I think the man who dodges bullets in mainstream media would be the better choice to carry our country through to the next generation. Okay, that is all. Get lost.